This is what you get when you open up the UI editor. So this is kind of like the base screen. And so we have kind of three columns going left to right. And so the elements panel has all of the various different UI components that you can put in your app that you can control with the UI editor. So we have, you know, action button, numeric inputs, plot outputs, cards, and plots and stuff like that. Everything that you would need to make a basic app, more of which are coming soon. So then moving over to the right, we have the kind of just app view. And this isn't like an exact view of your app. It's more of an abstract representation of the app with the intent of basically being a visual representation of the code. And the reason why is that a lot of times your actual app may have stuff like dynamic UI in it. And so we can't know what that would look like. So this is basically a way of, you know, we're going to put things in the right places and we're going to give you kind of the pertinent information. But it's, you think of it kind of as a wireframe of your app. And then to the right of that, we have the properties panel. And so if we select a given UI component in the app, like editor view, on the right hand side, you get to see the properties. And so you see where that given component is in the tree of your UI. So you have a grid page, within that you have a grid card, and within that you have the slider. So, and then you have the various settings like input ID, label, the values that you can change, and you know, all of these, you change them here and then it will update the app for you. You can delete that element down with this button. And then beneath that, there's a thing called the app preview. And so this goes back to the fact that this isn't like a perfect representation of your app. You see, like, this is not a real plot. It's just kind of an abstract plot. But down here, whenever you run the UI editor, you get a preview of the app. And so this is what the app looks like, you know, actually running. And as you change stuff within your app, that will update down there. So if we change the app title content to be Shiny UI Editor, and we go back here, we see that it changed here. And so you never have to turn off the UI editor and restart your app to see what it looks like. We'll do that automatically for you. We'll also give you like the logs that your app puts out. You can refresh the page in case there's something that changed that needs a page refresh. So yeah, that's the very basic set of tools. And then there's this panel up here that has a little bit of control. So say we do something like take this, move it down here, and then move our slider up to a new card over here. We say new slider. And then we say, wait a minute, I don't actually like that. We can use the back button up here to undo that change, go back all the way to where we were. Maybe we did like it, we can redo, but let's go back to that. So basically these undo and redo buttons are there to save you if you ever get yourself into a situation that you don't want to be in. You can always just back up until your app was working and looking the way that you want it to. So we talked about the element deletion. So say we want to delete this plot called blue plot, we can just click the delete element. You can see it down there, it's gone. But once again, let's put it back. Then we can do things like resize the given components. So say right now we have this slider on the left and the plots on the right. And then the plot on the top is the same size as the plot on the bottom. Maybe we want to make the plot on the top be, you know, maybe a little bit more of the given size. So we can just drag this little sizing down here, and you see the sizes pop up next to stuff, and it uses this thing called an FR, which we'll talk about in a little bit, but that's a CSS unit. So basically it's a ratio of the sizes. So we're going to say for every 0.5 units, the bottom plot, the top plot is 1.5. So it's going to be 3 times the size. We can stop there and go back and see, yep, it made that change. And so basically we can use this to fiddle around with the sizes. Say, you know, we're dragging this and we see it's 305 pixels, and say we really wanted it to actually be 300, we couldn't get our drag to be there. We can mouse over that and just go over here and type 300 and update it that way as well. I showed it a little bit before, but you can resize these panels within this grid by using these little handles, and then you can drag them down. So put our settings all the way down there. If you wanted to, maybe we'd use that to make this plot bigger. And yeah, you can configure everything to your heart's desire. It is using underneath the hood a package called Grid Layout, which we are releasing kind of in conjunction with Shiny UI Editor, which allows you to make your apps laid out very explicitly with grids. When you actually look, well, I guess we can talk about that later, but we just define where we want things to be, how big the given elements, the tracks of the grid are, the rows and columns of the grid, and then we can just put an element over whatever span of contiguous rows and columns that we want, and we know that it's going to be placed right there. We don't have to work with kind of arbitrary restrictions such as, you know, we can only have columns or we can only have rows. You can have both. Basically, if you can imagine it, you can put it into the grid layout. We can just add a bunch of columns if we want. And we do that by going over to these individual column views, and then you see there's a little plus button over here, and you mouse over, it says add a column, so we can do that. And then we just, you know, we get as many as we want. And so right now we have this name all scrunched up over there, but we could, you know, make it three of the columns, or, you know, whatever size we want to. We can resize, let's see, let's add a bunch of rows as well. You know, add one here. And we're getting a little bit crazy, but we can make that there. And then we can take our second plot, make it that. We have this kind of crazy grid structure, and what we could do is say, you know, let's put a text input here. So we can drag a text input, and we're going to call it, you know, name field or something like that. Put that there, and drag this bigger. You know, we could just keep going and building all sorts of arbitrary sizings. You know, we've got a title up here. Maybe we want to put our slider all the way up here. Probably drag this down a little bit so there's a little bit more space for it. Basically, the world is your oyster, so to speak, with what you put in this stuff. So yeah, we can build any design that you might possibly want, as long as it can be expressed as a grid. You can put it on here in Excel. You know, when you have, you want to add a column between things, you just kind of mouse up in this little area, right click here. You don't right click, you just hover, and it pops up this little interface. You can also delete rows, and so it will intelligently say, hey, you know, you can delete this tract because everything that's within it won't disappear, so we can delete that. But say we tried to delete this tract, it won't let us, and that's because if we delete it, you know, this whole element wouldn't have nowhere to go. And so you can simplify your, maybe you get your layout working the way you want to. You can then start taking out the various tracks to simplify, or you can leave them in. It's arbitrary. It doesn't really matter. You'll see that the code generated for grid layout, you know, it's easier to read if you have a simpler layout, but, you know, if you don't, it doesn't bother you. You can have your, have as many columns and rows as you possibly want, and you can make things look exactly how you want them to. Dynamic UI output is very literally just like output UI, render UI. Grid text card is when you just want to have place some text in the grid. And so it basically, like you see here, this title here is given, is just a grid text card. And so this is a just a component that you just want to put text somewhere, you put it in this. And so it's usually used for like a title of your app, maybe a footer. It's a pretty simple pretty simple function. Grid plot card is somewhat different. So see here, this is a grid plot card, and that can be put directly onto the grid page. And it's basically just like a shortcut for having a card. So like, this is a grid card. If you were to have a grid card and then put a plot in it, it's essentially the same thing. But a lot of times you just want to put a plot in a given place. So grid plot card does that, and it takes away some of the annoying details of, you know, you have to, if you've ever put a plot in a Shiny app, which I would assume a lot of people have, you know that it starts at 400 pixels high. And so almost always you're going to want to change that to some other value. And grid plot card is smart about that and knows that the grid is going to give you sizing of your plot for you. It will set those height and widths to automatically fill the card space that you have. And so that's kind of nice. Just allows you to skip some of the syntax and, you know, instead of having to have a card and then put a plot output in there and then make sure that the plot output has the right sizing, you can just drag grid plot card on there. And so that's just a, you could say, right, how we have this plot down here. So if we delete this plot and we put a plain card here and we call it just, you know, this plot, and then we take a plot output right here, we drag it in there. So this plot output needs to have this plot set, this plot. And you see that the height is 400 pixels. We want to set this to 100%. And then, you know, that's effectively the exact same thing that we get just for free with grid plot card. Another nice thing is that you notice that all of these cards have to have these names. You know, when we drag something new into here, it says you need to name this. And that's because grid layout needs to have some string to identify the given areas that you define on the grid. And a lot of times, if you're going to put a plot there, you probably are making that plot area the exact same string as the plot ID that you're using to hook up your plot. And so you can get that really easily with grid plot card. You put it down there, and we just call this dist plot. Say done. It automatically hooks it up to that dist plot argument. You don't have to do that. You see in the settings, name of grid area is dist plot, and then it automatically does that. But we could put a different output ID if we wanted to call it dist plot 2. It's going to break because dist plot 2 doesn't exist. The idea is that we give as nice a defaults as you could want for your plot. And then if you need more control, you would just put a plot in a grid card. So you'll notice when we put an element, so say we are going to drag, you know, the child of the grid layout needs to be a grid card of some kind. You know, we can directly put like the grid plot card there because that's a grid card. Right, it's a direct child. But if we take something like numeric input like we had before and we drag it here, it says you can put it on the grid. When we put it on the grid, it's going to ask us the name of this grid area. So we can say my numeric. But then if you actually look at this, you'll see that it wrapped it in a grid card. And so you still, this is a full card. You can put more stuff in here if you wanted. It depends. I think that's up to you, the app builder, if you want to start with placing your cards. You could basically empty your whole app like down to just a grid, just super simple. You know, you could say, okay, I want a bunch of columns and I want them all to be the same size. We make this one FR. So everything is going to be unique, like evenly sized, although this is 1.5. So we'll change that to one. So now we just have a grid. And then you could just take your cards and put them on there. Call this. No, plot A, position it around, and you could just continue to do that. Plot B, title, header, or something like that. If you wanted to, you could continue to do that. And then place your stuff on there. And honestly, if you wanted to, you could just use the UI editor to build this, get your layout, and then go into the code and add your stuff within those little built out skeleton. So it's kind of, we're agnostic about which way you do it. Sometimes you might want the control of putting the grid card directly, but know that anytime you put an item that is not a grid aware item, so it's not a grid card on it, it's going to just wrap it in a grid card for you. So you can save a step if you want, but you know, maybe you want to put titles here. So I say like plot A, and then, you know, you'll get a title for your card first. And so, you know, maybe you want to set it up that way instead of going back and retroactively assigning the settings for your given card.